गुड आफ्टरनून गाइस, दिस इज श्रेयस कपाले विद माय टीम सिद्धार्थ सत्यकामा, विष्णु जोशी एंड उमेश शिंदे। वी हैव बिल्ड दिस अमेजिंग एप्लीकेशन कॉल्ड एज बॉटल्स, विच इज अ इन्वेंटरी एंड सेल्स ऐप। नाउ लेट अस लुक एट व्हाट बॉटल्स एक्चुअली इज। इंट्रोडक्शन। बॉटल्स इज अ फुल्ली फंक्शनल रियल वर्ल्ड एप्लीकेशन फॉर इन्वेंटरी एंड सेल्स, क्राफ्टेड फॉर होलसेलर्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स। App is built using Flutter, Firebase Auth, Cloud Firestore, TensorFlow.js, and JavaScript. Now let us look at the tech stack. Inventory and sales system is built using Flutter, Firebase Auth, and Cloud Firestore. AI bottle recognition system is built using TensorFlow.js, HTML5, and JavaScript. The CD/CI is done using Travis CI. The continuous builds are deployed using Travis CI. Now let us look at the features. The features include ordering system with loan feature, sales management, automatic inventory management, global order search system, dynamic dashboard with sales report, and a bottle recognizer based on TensorFlow.js. Now the further part will be explained by Siddharth Satyakama.
Hello everyone, I am Siddharth Satyakama. I am going to explain UML diagrams, ER diagrams that are involved in this project Bottle App. So first of all, use case diagram for this project. We have two actors, customer and admin, that are interacting with different use cases that are involved in this system. So first, customer can log in, customer can select a drink, customer can order bottles, customer can pay bills and take loan from the company. Admin can log in, admin can check the inventory, admin can calculate profits, losses, and admin can have access to the customer details. And the next one is ER diagram for Bottle App. So we have six models ranging from admin, customer, customer details, product, order, payment. So first of all, admin. Admin have 5 attributes: customers, sales credit, inventory, earning, and logout functionality. Admin has a relationship with customer details, that is, admin can check the customer details. Admin has a relationship with payment, that is, admin can verify the payment. Then customer. Customer has 4 relationships, basically 4 foreign keys. Customer makes a payment, customer gives customer details to the database, customer can buy a product, customer gives order, or customer places an order. Customer details has 2 attributes, name and address. Product model has 4 attributes, soft drinks, followed by type of soft drinks, water bottles, followed by types of water bottles. And then order model has 3 attributes, item name, bottle piece, and quantity of items. Payment model has 2 items, amount to be paid and loan to be kept. And the next one is class diagram for admin. So basically, this class diagram represents a type of static structure diagram that describes the structure of a system by showing the system's classes. So in this, you can see we have admin, which is interacting with order details, inventory, and earning object. So admin has 2 attributes, username, which is a string value, password, which is a string value again, and it has a 1 method, that is login authentication. Then we have order details. Order details consists of 3 attributes, item name, bottle piece, quantity of items, and it has a single method, that is to fetch the order details. The next one is inventory. Inventory consists of 3 attributes, water bottles, soft drinks, and stock, and it has 3 methods, to fetch type of water bottle, to get type of soft drink, and to update the inventory. And the last one is earning. Earning consists of 3 attributes, ID, it is a unique generator ID assigned to the earning model, which is a string value, then paid, which is a date field on which date the payment has been done, and then total paid, which is an integer value. It also takes a single method, that is to calculate loan. Our next one is class diagram for customer actor. So we have customer, which is interacting with order, cart, and payment. Customer contains two attributes, which are name, address, and both are string fields. Customer contains two methods. First one is registration, and the second one is login authentication. Now we have order. Order consists of three attributes: item name, one bottle piece, and quantity of items. And it has two methods: place order and get order details from the database. Now we have cart. Cart consists of only two fields, that are water bottles and soft drinks. And it has three methods: to get type of water bottle, to get type of soft drink, and to update the cart. And the last one is payment, which consists of three attributes: ID, date of payment, and total paid amount. And two methods, that to fetch the payment amount and to get details about loan bottles. Now the last one, which is the sequence diagram for our bottle app. So this sequence diagram basically depicts the objects involved in this scenario and the sequence of messages exchanged between these objects needed to carry out the functionality of the scenario. So I will be explaining the complete sequence of this system from user, then admin, to order, to inventory, and the final payment. So first of all, user will register an account in the application interface. Then user will try to log in. If the login is authenticatedly successful in the database, then it will return a true value and user will be successfully authenticated to the application. Then user will places an order, and order will check if that product is available in the stock or not in the inventory. If the product is available, if yes, then order will be confirmed and order will be placed. If the inventory says that this product is not available at this time, then order will be cancelled and order need to be placed again. Now we have order placed. Now the final step, payment. Once payment made by the user, then payment verification will be done by the admin. If it's done, then order is going to be delivered to the user. And that's how this complete sequence goes. Thank you.
Hello guys, this is our app. It's called Bottles. It's a real world usage based inventory and sales application built for wholesalers and distributors. The app is built using Flutter and Firebase. It also uses TensorFlow.js for its AI part, which is a image detection system for bottles. Let us log in. So it has a basic login page wherein you can enter your username and credential, your password. So when you press login, you have this beautiful dashboard created by us, wherein there is a dynamic chart. Also there is a pie chart which shows distribution of the sales of different types of items. The chart is also animated, and it also has a marker wherein you can check the sales. Now let us look at its side pane. So side pane is also animated. So it has a scrollable feature wherein a person has logout, customers, earning page, inventory, sales, credit, and AI. Let us look at this one by one. Before that, let us add a customer to our page. So to add a customer, first we have to click that floating action button, and then we
go into the form where in the customer details should be entered. So for example, our customer name, let's say, is Rohan. So he lives in KLS Cokte College. Let us say he want 2 liters, and the price, let's say, 500 per unit, and the quantity is, let's say, 30 units. And let's add one more item, which is Apex 500, maybe, let's say. So let's say it's 100 rupees per bottle or per unit, and let's say 30 items in quantity added. This is also like scrollable, and you can also delete the items which you don't want, and then you hit next. After hitting next, you get the amount payable below the cash receiving part. So you have to enter the amount that you are going to collect from the customer. For example, let's say 2000, and automatically the calculation of the loan amount will be also generated and saved in onto the Firebase database. Let's say I am going to pay 2090 rupees right now, and I click on done. After you click on done, the order shows it's completed. Automatically the pie chart also updates. Currently it is in point value, so it is not updating. Now let us look at the inventory. So automatically the inventory also gets updated for Oxy. So it got updated. Now let us check the customer database. So automatically the customer with the date timestamp has been added, and we also get the amount of bill paid, which is 3000, and which is to be paid is 3000, and the paid amount is 2090, and the balance is 910. Now let us look at the sales credit section. So Rohan hasn't paid yet, Shreyas hasn't paid the loan yet, and also Rock hasn't paid the loan yet. So let us say we want to remove the person because he has completed his loan. So we say yes. So after that, what we can do is we can check the sales credit. Automatically he gets removed. So Rohan got removed from the sales page, the loan page. Now if you check the customers tab, Rohan will be still here because he's still a customer, but and he has no balance left, like he has paid all the amount completely. This also has a search bar wherein you can just type in the name. For example, Shreyas. If you say Rohan, or if you say just Ro, then it will show two of the suggestions. Then there is inventory. So in inventory is also updatable. For example, if you want Apex 200 liters to be updated to 103, which is our stock. So if I press save, it gets saved. And next time if you check it, it will be 103. It gets updated in the Firebase app part of the Firebase database. We are currently using Cloud Firestore, which is a real-time database by Firebase. So now let us look at the AI part. So the AI part is built in TensorFlow JS, and we have trained the model using a custom classifier. And based on the images of bottles, it recognizes the type of bottle we submitted. Let us press the scan button. Automatically, the permissions have been given. Now let us look at the Firebase console or the Firebase dashboard. In the Firebase dashboard,
We are currently using Cloud Firestore, which is a real-time database from Google. Now, there are two collections. One is inventory and orders. In inventory, we have the stock of different bottles. For example, if we check the Apex 2 liter bottle, it was recently updated in the app, just now as we updated it from the app. Now, let us look at the orders. So in orders, the document ID gets automatically created by, it is generated by the Firebase Firestore. Now, if you check, there is an entry called as Rohan, which we just now made from the app. And we can also see what type of item he ordered and the profit and the amount of payment he is left to pay. Now, it also generates a auto timestamp, which is also auto generated.
Thank you so much for watching.